This video touches on the misuse and abuse of linked lists and dynamic arrays. You should already know how each works from this playlist. After a quick investigation of their APIs, we'll take a look at some examples where you can go wrong. The main ideas of this video are fairly language independent, but the actual concrete examples are in Java. Java gives you these great linked list and array list classes with APIs that do tons of stuff, but you've got to look behind the scenes if you want to use them correctly. For instance, for linked lists, it currently says all of the operations perform as could be expected for a doubly linked list. You need to think about how linked lists work to avoid methods that work badly. Want to know if an item is in the structure? You could do a slow linear search to see if it's there, but you don't have to write that slow code. Slow code has conveniently been provided for you. The problem is that when people see the contains method listed in the API, it looks so tempting to use it without thinking about performance. But if you had to write that loop yourself, you might stop and wonder if this is really the data structure you want. Just to make it a touch more awkward, in Java, there's a list interface where either of these things can be used as a list. Again, with warnings if you look at the API closely enough. To use it, you should think about what both approaches do well. They can add to, remove from, or look at the end of a list, look at the front of a list, and return an iterator that can traverse the list in either direction at constant time per element. That's basically it. Each structure also has some extra ability. Linked list iterators can add or delete elements from their location in the list, and arrays give you direct access without inserting or deleting. Those functionalities complement each other. The linked list can be coded by just coding its iterator and tracking its size. All of the other linked list methods come from just manipulating its iterators. On the other hand, the array structure has all of the methods really coded in there, but its iterator doesn't need any special access. Its functionality comes from just keeping track of an index and then calling ArrayList methods. Finally, it should be mentioned that the constants tend to greatly favor the array-based methods. That's even more true in languages where you can store the objects instead of references to the objects. That isn't exactly a new method, but it is a strength. So starting with a simple example, here's some bad code to run through a list and get a sum. This is one that both structures can do well, but if you're lazy, you really hose yourself. For this code with an array list, it works great. Behind the scenes, this get method uses direct array access. But then you test it with a linked list. Behind the scenes, the get method is actually a loop on an iterator, and the performance sucks. Instead, if you properly use an iterator, both structures work well. The array list uses the iterator to look up an index for direct access, and the linked list uses the iterator to go through the list once instead of making a new iterator per item. Next, suppose that we have a list and we want to say filter out and remove all odd numbers. With a linked list, that's fine. You iterate through the list once and sometimes delete stuff. But for each of these deletions, the array list shifts over all the items after it. If you happen to delete every other item, the linked list will take linear time, the array list quadratic. You'd be better off creating a new array list out of the elements you want to keep, then deleting all contents from the original array list, and then refilling it with stuff from your new list. Next, let's say you have a list and you only insert to the end of it, and every inserted value is bigger than the previous one. Here, the items are in sorted order. To search the list for items, you can always do a linear search, but for the array-based model, you can use binary search, which takes only logarithmic time. But if you were so foolish as to use binary search on a linked list, each of those logarithmic number of accesses could take linear time, so it can take order n log n to find if an item is in the list, worse than linear time. Wow, that's fantastically bad. Here we see that on rare occasions, when the list only changes very infrequently compared to lookups, or if it's already sorted, the array model can take advantage of a sorted list when the linked list can't. But if the list has frequent changes at arbitrary positions, neither model will handle sorting well. When the APIs look so similar, or when you use the list interface, you have to be careful not to use methods that are inefficient for the data structure you're using, even if they're good for the other one. Having the same methods for these two APIs makes it really easy and convenient to write inefficient code without realizing it. It might be better if some of those methods weren't there. That list interface is really misleading. When you learn about it, you have this impression that it's a great convenience, allowing the same code to work on different structures. Then you might write some code and test it with both data structures, and it looks great because it works. And as a new programmer, you walk away happy. But maybe you only tested on like 100 items, and with such a small list, it looks good enough and you don't realize the inefficiency hit on your code. In truth, unless the code is limited to just those few overlapping methods mentioned at the start, it might work well with one data structure, but not the other. If you include the add method with an index, and the index is frequently in the middle of the list, your code will be slow no matter which list structure is used, even though the code doesn't look terrible at a glance. For list interface, generally stick to the really simple methods that work well with both arrays and linked lists. If you know you have a linked list, you can allow the iterator to change the list, but not with random access. Arrays allow random access to look at or change values, but only insert or delete at the end. You need to know how these structures work in order to understand the performance of each method in their APIs. Know which methods are real and which ones are just there for convenience. There's a video out there, a talk by someone who knows way more than me about programming and languages, telling you to avoid linked lists instead of vectors. He gives an example shown to him by somebody who knows way more about algorithms than me. But it's kind of a weird example because in it, both structures take average linear time per add and delete. Both suck. Using that example to prove that vectors are better than linked lists is like saying spoons are better than forks because spoons can hammer a nail more easily. Their example shows that constants for array lists are much better than they are for linked lists, and explains why, especially when you store objects directly instead of storing references. But they probably overreach in the conclusion to avoid linked lists for vectors. So don't make that mistake. Think about the code hidden behind convenience methods. Don't use those convenience methods unless it would have made sense for you to write that code in that place. If you really want a sorted structure that handles frequent changes with good performance, it's probably time to switch to a more sophisticated data structure like a balanced search tree. That's it for this one. I'm ready to watch the fight.
In this corner, linked lists, and in the other corner, array lists.